was full winter. And, you know, I began to live out there, but I couldn't take it up there. It was much too severe. You know, there was Roshi, who was Japanese, and the head monk was German, you know. And I thought this was the revenge of World War II, because they had a bunch of Americans up there, you know, walking in sandals through the snow and being, you know, beaten in the Zendo with sticks. And I thought, you know, this is really not the place for me. So I ran away. But there was something about Roshi that I remembered. So several months later, I came back again, and then I began to study with him and practice with him. I began to study seriously about 30 years ago. That is spending, you know, several months of the year with him all the time. In 1993, I think it was, I moved into the Zen Center on Mount Baldy, and afterwards I was ordained as a monk of Roshi's. You know, if Roshi had been a professor of physics in Heidelberg, you know, I would have learned German and moved to Heidelberg. I just felt that there was something that Roshi had to show me. And since I was there and looking after him as my job in the monastery, it was appropriate that I become ordained, because that was just the procedure. So I became a monk, but just formally, so that the protocol could be observed. You know, Roshi happens to be a Zen master and a Zen monk, you know. As he said to me in one of our first personal encounters, formal encounters, he said, "I not Japanese, you not Jewish." You know, so, you know, Roshi not Zen master and Leonard not Zen student, you know, other versions of ourselves might arise that are more interesting. And so he became a part of my life and a deep friend in the real sense of friendship, someone who really cared about, or didn't care, I'm not quite sure which it is, who deeply didn't care about who I was. Therefore, who I was began to wither. And